Welcome back, eKids Masked Singer fans. We're back with our esteemed judges, Lauren and Jordan. And we're so happy you're here because we are about to reveal the dancing dinosaur. Let's see who's behind that mask. And here's the reveal. Wow, the dancing dinosaur was Carlos Gomez, our youth pastor? I am blown away. He did such a fantastic job. What a performance and what a surprise.
Whoa. Okay, that's a good one.
Carlos, really good. Oh man, that was outstanding.
Wow, eKids Masked Singer fans, I'm still reeling from that reveal, but I cannot wait to meet our newest masked singer, Wonder Woman. You're gonna love this performance. Stay tuned after the So-and-So Show. Welcome back, eKids Masked Singer fans. Here she is, Wonder Woman.
Popped off the plane at LAX with a dream in my cardigan. Welcome to the land of fame, excess. Whoa, am I gonna fit in? Jumped in the cab, here I am for the first time. Look to my right and I see the Hollywood sign. This is all so crazy, everything seems so famous. My time is turning, I'm feeling kind of homesick. Too much pressure and I'm nervous. This afternoon, turn on the radio, and the Jay-Z song was on. It's a party in the USA. Yeah, it's a party in the USA.
What a performance! Amazing! Judges, tell us, what did you think about her performance?
I love that song, and she did a pretty good job with it too. But it just sounds so
familiar.
Yeah.
I'm perplexed. And well, yeah, it was quite a performance.
It was great.
I'm just really confused.
It was super. Get it, Wonder Woman? Super?
Wonderful.
Well, I have my ideas about who Wonder Woman could be, but judges, what are your guesses?
Well, I'm pretty sure that I know that voice. It just seems so familiar to me. And I've been watching a lot of our eKids preschool show, and I'm pretty sure maybe this is why it's so familiar. I think it's my friend Diana.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, maybe.
It could be, but I'm actually kind of worried about this one. I don't know if I can even share my answer. It just is so eerily familiar. I gotta pass. I can't even share my answer on this one.
Well, you have to share.
I can't do it.
You have to give him. He has to give a guess.
Secret ballot.
No.
There's some debate about who she could be. I think we should go ahead and reveal her right now. Wonder Woman, take off that mask. It was Anne Ross? I am blown away. She was amazing. Who knew she had those kind of moves? That was fantastic. I'm so surprised. Judges?
Hey everyone, welcome off stage again. Hey, you know, as we talk about focusing on the truth, I was thinking back to a time back when I was in high school, and I had this poster that I got and put up on my wall, and it had all these different names of God. It was a pretty cool poster. I actually just looked on Amazon, and you can still find it on there. But you know, when I think about that, I think about some different times in my life that were really challenging. And you know what one of the really cool things is that when I would look up on my wall in my room and I would see that poster, I could always find a different name, a different descriptor of God that brought me comfort or that helped me feel a little bit better and understand God and understand my situation a little bit better just by being reminded of that, no matter what. So it says in the Bible that God is our anchor. And you know, when we're going through stormy situations, sometimes life is messy, right? And you know what? God is our anchor. He is strong, and he's what keeps us grounded even in the messiest of stormy situations. You know, it also says that God is like a star, like a morning star. And that means that when we're feeling lost or alone, that we can look to him, we can talk to him, we can pray to him, we can write a letter to him, and that we can look to him, and he is a bright spot, even when everything else seems dark, or if we feel lost. So you know what? It also says that he's the author and the finisher of our faith. He's the beginning and the end. So no matter where you're at in your story right now, you can know that God is there. He's with you. He's been there with you before, and he's going to be there with you again. And that is a truth that you can focus on.